In electronics, we know that certain circuits can have very strange effects in terms of how to connect transistors to the positive and the negative lead. And here, that's very strange. It's a reversed NPN transistor. Normally, we connect to the collector here, the positive, and to the emitter, negative. But here it is reversed. We have 12 volt positive here on the emitter and a negative lead to the collector. And that gives strange effects. There is an earlier video on my YouTube channel and also on the World Wide Web. You will find much more information that you can use a reversed NPN transistor as a sawtooth generator. I don't see this effect here, but there's a video on my channel where I demonstrate it. Here we have the BC547 NPN silicon transistor. Now in the emitter lead, a LED and a resistor, pin connections, etc. And when you do this and supply the circuit with 12 volts or 13 volts, doesn't matter, you will see that that transistor oscillates more or less in a spontaneous way. I cannot explain it, but it is a well-known phenomenon. Perhaps on other YouTube channels, etc., etc. It oscillates somewhere here or here because of the random way. That it oscillates, the frequency counter is not able to give a precise reading. That doesn't matter anyway. The most important thing of that circuit is here, that you can use it as a trigger circuit. This is in my book, Schematic 3 out transistor switches, generators and cathode ray tube circuits. Published it a few years ago, and here you see the same circuit here. These diodes protect the base to a too high voltage so that it cannot be damaged. And here we set the supply voltage that's going in from the sink unit. And this transistor here has that specific role. It acts as a kind thyristor. So according to the frequency that comes in here from the sink unit, it breaks down on its collector emitter and then drives this square wave generator, the time-based circuit. Sorry, the sawtooth generator, not the square wave, but the sawtooth generator drives the sawtooth generator on the pulses that come in out of the vertical supply of the scope. And here is that complete circuit. For more information, buy my book. When you want to make a very simple scope, oscilloscope, and anyway, that was more or less all to tell. Here we have that circuit again on the breadboard. It oscillates spontaneously. It doesn't give out a very precise frequency. But when we try to drive that, say, thyristor, transistor, thyristor, of course not a real thyristor, kind of fake thyristor, though it works in this application, of course not on other applications. Take distance, take your time. This only works in this specific application. We can see that the generator gives out a certain frequency and a certain voltage, output level here, duty cycle to the middle, output level here, frequency, and you can see that the spontaneous oscillations of that one transistor circuit has a very substantial effect on the frequency that's generated on via that generator. So it's only a demonstration. The only thing that I wanted to tell is that you can use such a reverse transistor as a kind of trigger unit to trigger whatever you want. When the voltage on the base exceeds a certain value between the collector and the emitter, the voltage breaks down, and that's usable in certain electronic applications, especially trigger circuits.